Do I have raccoon dogs in my backyard? They've certainly been in the news a lot lately, taking the blame for the origins of COVID-19. Should I be getting up close and personal with these raccoons? And are they raccoon dogs? Well, I've devised a series of tests to find out. So, what are the basics we know about dogs? One, they beg for food. Two, they like to be pet. Three, they love to play. And four, probably the most important of all, is they go bonkers over squeaky toys. So watch closely while I put these raccoons through all four tests. And if they pass, well then, God help us all. So far, we've learned that yes, they beg for food. No surprise there. But walking, clapping, and talking raccoons? Weird. But how about, do they like to play, and do they play sports? So I went about constructing a soccer field to see if they want to play. Thank you. They've arrived. Time to explain the rules to you and to the Oons. So, I get a point when the cookie rolls into the goal. They get a point when either I miss a shot or they block a shot. See if you can keep score. Goal! Can you believe it? Raccoons playing soccer. But will they play with dog toys? And how about squeaky toys? Watch, you might be surprised by the results. Good boy. They failed the final test. Crisis averted. I guess they're not raccoon dogs. Now that I think about it, these guys might be raccoon cats? So, who's to say what wild animal might infect us next? This deer could give us chronic wasting disease. We might catch cat scratch fever. And for her, it's impossible to say which virus she could carry. My money is on the Squabitt. Cute but deadly. Our urban backyards can be filled with awe and wonder. Just hang up a bird feeder, sit back and watch. Just about anything could happen. Thanks for watching, and happy OONSDAY. If you liked the video, please subscribe.